Hi, I'm Laura Shervanek, and I'm the Vice President of Professional Development at ExploreLearning. I'm here today to talk about student readiness in building fluency in addition and subtraction math facts. Reflex is a highly engaging program that helps students to build fluency with their math facts. We know that students are ready to build automaticity using Reflex only after they have conceptual understanding of the operations that are involved. So the obvious question is, how do we know that a student really understands addition and subtraction? Well, Dr. Michael Batista developed an approach to math instruction called cognition-based assessment, and that provides a framework to assess and instruct students, and it focuses on deep understanding and reasoning. I would encourage you to learn more about cognition-based assessment and teaching from Dr. Batista's book, Cognition-Based Assessment and Teaching of Addition and Subtraction. For the purposes of assessing students' readiness for reflex, we're concerned with the very basic levels of development of students' reasoning with addition and subtraction, levels 0 and 1. In the CBA Framework's level 0, students don't understand addition or subtraction situations. They may be able to count a single set of objects, but they don't understand how to join or separate two sets. Level 1 in the framework describes the student who adds or subtracts numbers as collections of single units, or ones. This level is further divided into several sublevels. Level 1.1 includes students who count all to solve a problem. Level 1.2 includes students who count on or count down from a number. And at level 1.3, a student recalls a fact from memory or derives it from another fact that is known from memory. So students who have achieved at least level 1.2, counting on or counting down, are ready to begin learning their facts from memory and building automaticity with both addition and subtraction. Let's take a look at an interview with a student to determine his level of reasoning in the CBA framework. So I'm going to give you some problems, and when I'd like to know what you're thinking while you're solving those problems. So kind of think out loud while you do them. Can you do that for me?
Yeah.
Okay. And then I may ask you some questions if I don't quite understand what you're thinking as you solve them.
Okay.
So Julian had 4 blocks, and he got 3 more blocks. How many blocks does he have?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
7 blocks? Nice. Good job. I'll tell you what, I'll give you... Let's try another one. Dennis has 8 cubes. 1, 2, 3. We'll just give you a whole bunch. And you can use those if you need to solve it, okay?
Okay.
Dennis has 8 cubes, and he gives 3 of them to his friend. How many cubes does he have left?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5.
He has 5 left? Good job. All right, let's try this one. What's 8 plus 9?
19.
As you can see here, the student attempts to start with 8 fingers and count on, but he's unable to get to the correct answer. So although he's almost ready for level 1.2, he's not there yet. Let's take a look at another student. Let's see. Your brother, Carlos, has 4 cubes, and his friend gives him another 3 cubes. How many cubes does he have?
7.
How do you know that?
Because 4 plus 3 equals 7.
Okay, all right. So then we're going to say you have 8 cubes, and you give 3 of them to Carlos. How many do you have left?
5.
How do you know that?
Because 8 minus 3 equals 5.
Okay. All right. So what's 8 plus 9?
17.
How did you do that?
Well, 9 plus 1 equals 10, and then 7 plus 10 equals 17.
Okay. All right. And how did you get the 7?
From the 8.
From the 8. Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome. This student is consistently at level 1.3. He can recall facts from memory and derive facts from others. Students with a firm standing in level 1.2 or above are ready to build fluency with Reflex because they show understanding that cardinal numbers represent actual numbers of objects. This abstraction shows they can begin learning to recall facts from memory and then build fluency. I hope this video will help you in determining which of your second graders are ready to start building fluency with their math facts in addition and subtraction. I do recommend that you read Dr. Batista's work to gain further insights into instructional strategies that you can use to help your students get that conceptual understanding that they need so that they can start building fluency with Reflex. Thank you for watching this video. For more information on Reflex, go to reflexmath.com.